This week, we're set ablaze with praise, and we go sideways for a dance craze. Yes, it's one of those days. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the Ekko. In Hastings High School, the Ekko is back with the 8th episode of this 11-show season. I'm your anchor, Ian Andrysiak. Your mind may be on prom, but we've still got a week to go for that big event. Today is Friday, May 10th, 2019, and we have some exhilarating stories to share with you, starting off with a recent field trip. For a whole day last week, the French classes took a trip to St. Paul for the Festival of Nations. It's a celebration of different countries and cultures, with traditional food, souvenirs, and so much more. This huge multicultural extravaganza has been recognizing the rich cultural diversity in the Twin Cities area for the last 86 years.
What I love about it is I used to make kids do passports, you know, go to this many countries and get information. I don't do that anymore because I feel like the kids go there for different reasons. Some really enjoy the food and, you know, they go out in groups and sample lots of different foods. Other kids love the shopping experience or a combination thereof.
Turns out, that wasn't the only special affair the Global Language Department was making recently. Instead of another field trip, it was an opportunity to say Feliz Cumpleaños all day long with the Gran Fiesta. On Friday, April 26th, the Spanish students were treated to a whole day of delicious food, wacky games,
Las Hermanas,
and lots of fun after finishing a unit on, well, birthdays. They even smashed student-made piñatas every hour, and we managed to get away with just a little bit of candy ourselves. If you're on the lookout for more fun and good food, one place you might want to check out is in the 3B pod. Every other Friday morning at exactly 7:14 in one particular room, you can find students, teachers, fellowship, and something to eat too. It's time for a huddle. Here's the Ekko's Emily Beyer.
3B, backpacks, donuts, Mr. Lutz, and fellowship, it's FCA.
It stands for Fellowship of Christian Athletes. It's a club we meet in Mr. Lutz's room, like every other Friday, roughly.
Billy is one of the huddle leaders.
That is centered around the idea of athletes and coaches being able to get together and fellowship together, grow in their faith, share in relationships and kind of life experiences, and just be an encouragement to each other.
Every other Friday, students gather in Lutz's room to engage in deepening their faith.
We just talk about our Christian faith and specifically how it relates to being an athlete.
Anyone is invited to go, despite being in athletics or not.
You know, if you come, if you're not an athlete, you're not a Christian, you just want to check it out, you absolutely can come. And if you just like to be there, you absolutely can come and just hang out with the people, eat the donuts, you know, soak it all in for sure.
In addition to FCA huddles, FCA also hosted Fields of Faith.
Fields of Faith every year is super powerful always, and yeah, it's awesome.
To share a night together in song and praying for the community, praying for our leaders, praying for our school, and it's just a great kickstart to our FCA year.
Fields of Faith isn't just in our high school.
It's a national event. It happens on the same night nationwide at fields all across the country.
FCA is in 62 countries and there are 17,783 certified huddles.
It's gotten a lot bigger. The huddle leader team has gotten bigger as well. There are a lot more leaders than when I started. More people come, and like especially the events, a lot more people come to the events, and there's just like a lot more new people showing up.
And his favorite part?
My favorite part about FCA, obviously the donuts.
FCA integrates faith into students' lives by
going to like a setting where you're in school with your friends and you're talking about Jesus, you're talking about your Christian faith.
FCA is a great place to be every other Friday morning, but why can we have a Christian affiliation in a public high school?
primarily because it is a national organization and it's most importantly a student-led organization.
The huddle leaders choose what is discussed.
I learn with the rest of the audience that morning. It's the first time that I've seen it and get to witness it is on Friday mornings.
Fellowship of Christian Athletes have played a big part in building relationships.
We get to have really close relationships, and I think they get to see me for who I am, what I really stand for, what I believe in, is really why I'm a teacher in the first place. It's about the relationships for me.
With the experience of being a huddle leader, Billy may take his leadership skills to the next level.
Being a priest, going into ministry of some kind is definitely something that I've thought about.
FCA has not only impacted Billy, our community and students have been affected in positive ways and will continue to for years. This is Emily Beyer reporting for The Ekko.
FCA has made some great contributions for the Hastings community and is still growing year after year. Make sure to check them out when you get back to school next fall for even more fun, rain or shine. That wasn't quite the case the other day for another Raiders activity, however, as precipitation put a damper on some big plans. What do you do when the rain won't go away? Let's hand the baton off to the Ekko's Allison Amy.
Is that thunder I hear? No. It is raining, though, but these track stars won't let the rain keep them down.
Yeah, I mean, we're doing the best job we can. The kids are doing everything that they're asked of them. Sometimes we have to make up some weird workouts, or we have to just do with what we can.
And these students are doing everything they can to cross that finish line.
I'm training hard to get faster for my team and for myself.
Senior Amar Thomas goes the extra mile. And in other sports, too.
I coached Amar in football and in wrestling and trained him in the summer.
He puts his heart into everything he does.
He has nothing but heart. Like, he just puts it on the line every time.
Amar's a stand-up kid. He does the right stuff. He shows up. He works hard.
And another former coach of his can agree.
He came to work every single day, worked hard.
And his hard work is paying off.
I just love to run as fast as I can, beat people, make them look slow.
But Amar isn't all about track.
He gives up his class time to go work with the adapted FIAD students down in the gym.
There, he found a passion for helping others.
I'm more than excited that he's going to pursue human services. Like, I think he wants to pursue special education.
Amar is going to Waldorf University in Iowa with a scholarship for track and field. There, he plans on pursuing human services.
I'm going to college for special education. So I can pursue working with kids like that.
And maybe he'll even come back to Hastings High School.
I hope to come back to the school and work with kids like them and just be able to see the teachers when I'm older, when I'm an adult.
The teachers here would love to see him come back.
I'm being selfish here, but I would love to see him back here and he could, you know, and have him coaching with our kids and just giving back to this community.
I hope he comes back to Hastings and teaches here. I'd love to have him be a colleague, continue to make impacts here at Hastings High School.
Whether or not Amar returns to Hastings High School, his contribution to this community won't be forgotten.
I like to run. Just running, it's kind of fun.
So next time you hear thunder, it might just be another track star training for their next endeavor. I'm Allison Amy, reporting for The Ekko.
Good luck, Amar, in all your future endeavors. In the very near future, you'll be hearing a lot about something called senior privileges. And you'll be seeing a lot of these colorful lanyards throughout the school. And with these special lanyards, many seniors in the building will be able to cash in a lot of shiny opportunities, such as heading out for lunch at, say, Chipotle or Subway. And the privileges don't stop there.
The biggest senior privilege is if you are passing all of your classes for graduation and you are in class and on time and doing the things that you've done every day throughout your senior year, you get those last 5 days of school off. We also do a fast track lane for lunch, so seniors get to walk to the lunch line and they're first, so they really like that. Senior privileges will start on Monday, May 13th, and each senior will get a lanyard with their picture on it that has to be visible, so study hall teachers know that they have a senior badge. The fast track lunch line knows that they have a badge. When it comes to open lunch, they'll show their badge. So it's really important that seniors wear their senior lanyard loud and proud.
And of course, we can't forget about the all-night grad party. Right after graduation on June 7th, seniors also have an entire night of good times with games, food, tons of prizes, and even a hypnotist. Last year, over 90% of the graduating class attended. So make sure to get your tickets now at the discounted price of $80 before they get marked up to $100 at the door. And now for something completely different. A high-intensity activity that doesn't include a ball, but may include going to a ball. Let's hit the dance floor as the Ekko's own Nate Klinger takes the lead with this story. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Dance is an activity for all ages. Located in Schoolhouse Square, Just for Kicks has classes for anyone ranging from 3 years old to seniors in high school.
This job is full-time, but it's my fun job, so it doesn't feel like work.
Tori Eibinger has been coaching for a long time.
9 years as of this year. I started my coaching in Farmington Just for Kicks, and I continued in Hastings.
And she has taught many students. But one of them in particular stands out.
She started dancing with me 2 years ago.
Maggie Corum, a junior at HHS, has only been dancing for 5 years.
I quit like halfway through middle school, and then I just wanted to be in a sport, so then I rejoined.
But her personality and moral compass make her stand out from the crowd.
Not only does Maggie dance, but she also coaches younger students.
Maggie has been helping Tori coach younger students ever since she got back into dance.
She's great in class. She listens well. She takes my criticism and applied it right away. She was quick to help others. She's been awesome. She's been wonderful. I asked her because I saw that determination to be the best dancer she could be, and I knew she could help other kids do the same.
Toddlers, middle schoolers, and high schoolers have all been helped by Maggie this year.
She knows how to teach the kids.
Either as a mentor or as a friend.
We had a dance sleepover.
Maggie does such a good job.
I can, you know, say, hey, let's come over to my place and learn a dance quick, and then you can teach it while I'm gone.
That she can be trusted to teach the classes alone.
I actually called in sick, and she came in and taught class that whole night.
The effort that Tori and Maggie put into their work,
she kind of just gets me going and gets everybody up and at 'em,
has led to lots of awards.
So we just went to nationals, and the teams that I coach got fourth twice, third once, and then the teams that I'm in got second and then fourth.
A lot of our competitions.
I think I like the competitions.
You know, her reactions are awesome. They've captured them on pictures, and then, you know, she's one of the first I hug.
And although most students don't continue extracurriculars after high school, Maggie plans on following a different route.
Yeah, I could see it carrying out after high school.
Whether she decides to continue with dance.
Dance is a way that you can, like, express yourself.
Or pursue another career.
I maybe want to be a counselor or a teacher.
Dance will always play a critical part in Maggie's life. This is Nate Klinger, reporting for The Ekko.
If that story got you spinning, find Maggie in the halls and ask for more details. Hey, you won't want to miss next week's show. It's her annual all-prom episode. It's going to be a wallop of a good time. And don't forget, it's Mother's Day this Sunday. Grab your mom a plant from Mr. DeWall's greenhouse sale going on today until 5. I'm Ian Andrysiak. It was a blast anchoring on the show today. Thanks for catching us again on The Ekko.
You're on the couch, blowing up my phone. You don't wanna come out, but you don't wanna be alone. It don't take but two to have a little soiree. If you're in the mood, sit tight right where you are, babe. Cause I'll be at your door in 10 minutes. Whatever you got on, girl, stay in it. You ain't gotta leave the house to have a good time. I'm gonna bring the good time home to you. We'll have a